This is AM Agenda. Now to my interview this morning with Conservative Liberal Senator David Fawcett. And I asked him, was he disappointed that his amendments proposed last night on greater religious protections on the same-sex marriage bill, that they were voted down?
I am, because the issues are valid issues that were raised with us during the Senate Select Committee that considered these things in detail at the start of the year. And so whilst the political momentum here will probably move on, I look at, for example, the two pastors in Tasmania who are currently before the Anti-Discrimination Tribunal there for speaking their view on traditional marriage and the reality of that kind of situation for them, of being hauled up before a tribunal for expressing their genuinely held religious beliefs, is a very real thing for them.
Were you surprised that not only did yours and Senator Patterson's amendments not succeed, but nor did those put forward by the Attorney General and Resources Minister Matt Canavan? They were knocked down as well. And they were much more modest in terms of their scope.
Well, I mean, some of them were very much identical. In fact, one of the things that disappoints me is that it appeared that people came in with a mindset to oppose the amendments regardless of the content. If you look at the issue around civil celebrants, the model that had been proposed by the Senate Select Committee was to create a new category of traditional marriage celebrants. Senator Smith, in his bill, had recognised that was valid, but on a grandfather provision for civil celebrants who weren't the pastors of small congregationally governed churches. What we said was, look, if it's valid in a transitional sense, it should be valid ongoing. But people seem to have come in with the view that what we were proposing was to allow every civil celebrant to choose whether or not to marry a same-sex couple. So they hadn't actually considered the detail, and that came out during the debate. So I'm hopeful that as people consider a few of the amendments, whether they are the Attorney General's or the ones that I put up with James, that as we look towards the debate in the House, that perhaps there will be some discussion, because there were offers made to discuss some of these issues, and those offers weren't taken up with Dean. So I'm hoping as some of those issues have come out, some of those understandings have been clarified during the Senate debate, that perhaps in the House there can be an agreement reached as to where some sensible common ground is.
And then it might come back to the Senate for a final decision next week, potentially.
If it was modified in the House, it would come back to the Senate.
Now, you're obviously not placated by the reassurances of Senator Birmingham, for example, this morning, who says that the Smith bill has enough religious protections already. It does not stop a synagogue, a mosque, a church from refusing a same-sex couple from being married there, and he thinks it's sufficient.
Yeah, so look, one of the basic misunderstandings in this whole issue is that it's not federal law that actually causes the issue. It's the interaction between federal law and state and territory anti-discrimination law. And that was what the Senate Select Committee found. And so whilst a lot of people have referred to it as a consensus report, the consensus was largely that there were serious issues that needed to be discussed in detail. And the comment that was made in the report was, if we were to legislate to change the definition of marriage, then we would need to have these discussions so that we kept Australia as a plural community where a diversity of views were both accepted and legal. I think valued and legal is the words that were used. So the federal legislation is not the issue. It's the interaction with state legislation, because across the country, every state and territory has legislated for anti-discrimination law, but only the ACT has legislated comprehensively for religious freedom.
Well, in that sense, though, wouldn't you then see that as the task for the committee set up sure, under Philip Ruddock and others, the Human Rights Commissioner and Frank Brennan, the eminent Jesuit scholar, that those individuals can come up with a framework with which you can then establish via legislation sure, those religious freedoms?
And so I've spoken to Philip about that. I chair the Joint Standing Committee on Foreign Affairs, Defence and Trade, and the Human Rights Subcommittee has actually been looking at religious freedoms in Australia. And I anticipate that Mr Ruddock will use that report, which should come out in the next week, as the basis for looking at how you implement that. But what I pointed out during the debate, and I've pointed out in other places, is that the last time we attempted to do this was under Nicola Roxon when she was the Attorney General. And the process became so complex, with each of the state and territory legislatures not wanting to give up what they thought was appropriate in terms of those laws, that in the end it was shelved.
So you're worried it'll be mired in complexity and negotiation, there will be no protection then?
Well, potentially there'll be no protection, or potentially it will take some time. And as I say, as we speak, there are two people in Tasmania who are before a tribunal, despite the assurances that Senator Smith brought from the Taxation Commissioner that he wouldn't issue any rulings that affected charities. We've seen courts overrule the Taxation Commissioner on multiple occasions when rulings have been issued. And we've seen decisions made by anti-discrimination commissioners in Queensland. We've seen decisions made by the National Charities Commission, which go to the very status of charities around these issues.
Would you like Mr Turnbull to show more leadership in this regard, as Andrew Broad, the Nationals MP, has asserted this morning? Or do you think this is something that needs to be thrashed out on the floor of Parliament, as this is a private member's bill?
Well, look, it is a private member's bill. Mr Turnbull took to the election the commitment to let the Australian people have their say. He's delivered that. He took to the election a commitment that would be a conscience vote for the coalition, and he's delivered that. I think it's incumbent now on people of goodwill on both sides of this debate to try and find that middle ground so that the nearly 4 million Australians, nearly 5 million Australians, who hold the view that marriage is between a man and a woman can continue to express that view in an appropriate legal way.
So you don't share the view of Mr Broad and others that this should be a party room decision and something that Mr Turnbull needs to lead on?
Look, I think we've always said that these sorts of issues are a conscience vote when it comes to this. We have had positions in the past where the party said this is the definition in the law, but since we've said we'd have the plebiscite, our position has been it would be a conscience vote after the plebiscite.
Senator David Fawcett there speaking to me earlier this morning. That's all for AM Agenda. We've got Live Now next with Ashley Gillard.